Welcome back. Today we're going to play the Antichess Arena. It's a nice way to get back into the swing of things and play a variant I haven't played in quite some time. Maybe reacquaint myself with some of it and just have some fun playing some variants because I haven't done much of that lately. I see that fire starter's here, so this should be a tough event. Yeah. I'm not the favorite to win it, but maybe I could play well anyhow. It's going to be a learning experience, guys. Alright. Let's see, C5. So, that is a line. It's perfectly legit. And I don't remember how it goes. I'm just going to sack my bishops and see what happens. So there goes bishop number one. Actually, I could sack my knight here. And then... Oh, I see. That makes it harder for me to go through with my plan. It's going to say I could sack the knight and sack the bishop pretty easily. And have control of the board. There seems to be a complication here. Alright, so let's get the queen out here. Obviously, he's not going to let me take on g7. I'm not sure what else he's going to do. Well, I said obviously he's not going to let me take, and now I'm kind of forced to take. So, down the rabbit hole we go. I am ahead by one piece, so if we ever end up in a capturing race at the end, I'll still be ahead by one. And by ahead, I mean I have one fewer. So that's why I'm not so concerned. I can just pretty much throw this out there and just see what happens. Queen g8 tends to work in a lot of these openings, and I'm going to guess that it works here. So far, I've been playing mostly by intuition. I did not expect that move, because usually that particular move does not work. Maybe in this very specific situation, there might be some merit to it. I'd be surprised. Nope, that would lose the initiative. So, trying to figure out what to do about the G pawn. Well, here's a thought. Let's get a capturing race going this way. So I'm already ahead by two pieces. So if his rook is loose and my rook is loose, really anything could happen. But in most lines, I'm going to have two fewer pieces than he'll have. So almost every possible race that could happen is going to be in my favor. So again, I'm ahead by two, so not really much for me to worry about here. I can just take that, he takes something, I take something, and in all of these races, it's just gonna favor me. It's more or less that simple. Okay, this is eventually forced, so let's get that taken care of right away. All right, and this is eventually forced. I don't want to do rook takes g7, so I want to do this right away also. Okay, that was hasty on my part. That was ridiculously hasty. I should have taken e7. Well, I'm not sure it matters. No, I could play bishop a3, and then I take either e7 or f8, and this is all good. So, how did I, so I'm applying my own custom user style to the site. If you've got any kind of plugin for your browser, you can customize any web page to look how you want it to look. So if you want these colors, just apply that particular style and you're good to go. Now I want to get my knight out to b5 here. Actually, if you leave all the pawns alone, I could even play knight to c3. And now I'm threatening knight d5 as well as knight b5. Yeah. Well, I never know what you guys are going to say here on the stream, so that's why I have to categorize it that way if I'm going to have any kind of live interaction. It's a risk worth taking. There we go. Back to the tournament. Hey, look. Whoa, I'm in second. Guy in first place has quit. And there's numerous guys all rated way, way higher than myself. So, yeah, if I win this, it's a fluke. We'll put it that way. Yeah, I'm not going to win it. It is still kind of cool being tied for first for a fleeting instant. Well, no, I was tied for first when the tournament began. We all had zero. But now... there's a two-way tie for first, and I just happen to be lucky guy who gets paired with this dude. All right. Well. I don't know this theory as well as this guy does. So I know I can do this. I don't know anything else about it. So this is gonna be fun. I'm going to guess bishop h6. It just feels right. Okay, now do I do king takes, knight takes, or queen takes? Seriously tempting to do queen takes, and then queen takes d7, queen takes e2. We capture. No, that's bad. Knight takes might be okay. Or queen takes, and if he takes d7, I take there. We'll give it a try. So he takes here. I was thinking knight takes. This could go poorly very quickly. I think king takes is forced. And it's losing, so that's kind of bad. We're gonna try this. This seems to be the trickiest continuation. But it's pretty simple, because he does king d1 and then g4. Or he does the simpler thing. Wait. Is there a forced win here? Well, let's find out. Let's take this a few moves out. Okay. So I've survived. In hindsight, knight f6 is probably stronger on my part. Oh well. Knight there, knight takes, knight takes. Pawn takes, pawn takes. Not seeing the light at the end of the tunnel here. Knight c5, knight b6, knight b3, knight a8, knight a there, knight c7, knight c2, rook knight takes. That's no good. If he takes a8, I'm forced to take a1. He takes, yeah, so it's all forcing and not at all winning. Knight g4, knight b6, knight f2. Actually, yeah, he missed this. I think I take h2 here. And, oh, I missed that. I missed a one mover. That's okay. Oh, yeah, surely this is, well, I say surely this is lost. Let's see it. Yeah, you got me, you got me. Okay. Yeah, this is Chrome. So, not off to a bad start. Gonna play the famous 1e3. Everybody knows it except me. So, this can only go well. Here, let's bring the queen out. Everybody loves it when I do that one. I bet he's calculating bishop a6. Can I get away with queen takes d7? We're gonna find out. This feels right. Okay, I take you, you take me. We're a happy family. However that Barney song thing goes. Okay, you take my rook, I assume. Okay, and then you sack the bishop on h3. But g7's protected. Not just protected once, but twice. So I can sack here. This is still problematic. Because he's intending knight d7. I think I can get away with this, though. Yeah. I'm sure over time I'll get the hang of this game. But expect me to not win this event. It'll be kind of ridiculous if I did end up winning it. Okay, so he undefends his bishop. I'm kind of low on ideas at the moment. But yeah, his knight can't go too far. I didn't expect this. This looks really aggressive. Because I do that, and my rook's free. He can't bring his bishop out. Yeah, he did get rid of a rook, but where's his knight going? Oh, that's where it's going. Okay, that's a problem. I can't allow him to sack and let me take on e5, so I have to do it this way. It's forced. And now complications. Hmm. It's not even threatening g4. Wait, is g4 forced? No, he can move his rook up or down on the file. He can keep prolonging the inevitable. So I can do this. And then you go back up and down. Oh, wait, no, he blocks the bishop. No, if the bishop moves, though. Yeah, no, this happens. I'm pretty sure I do h4 here. F4, and then don't leave this protected. Place something else, but what? I'm thinking rook A3. I think e5's forced or best. Sack the rook, even though I'm kind of not very comfortable with this position. Let's push the rearmost pawn, give myself a tempo to think, and now we got an endgame. Part of this dwells on, is he going to push this e pawn? No, he should just push h3. H3 is pretty obvious. Problem with h3 is that now if I take his rook and promote to a rook. Okay, well that's not happening. This is forced. So do I take and get a rook? Rook. He sacks the bishop. I take. He pushes. Too slow there. But, I mean, if I don't take a rook, I'm pretty sure I'm losing this. We're gonna try a rook. Oh, golly, I miscalculated that. I cannot count. That was pretty pathetic. I calculated a lot of things. I even calculated that out the way it actually played out, and I thought to myself, surely I've miscounted this. So I did it a second and a third time, and I got it wrong every time there. So knight h3, we'll sack this. Why is he waiting? The fact that he hesitated there at all makes me wonder, did I just fall for some trap? Is this bad for me or something? Oh, if he plays g4, he's actually doing okay there. Usually you do king takes in this kind of situation, but I want to get this knight into position to sack it. But yeah, this is disadvantageous. have to take there, because the other move order allows him to well, sack a constellation of pieces. Oh, but if I go to e5 now, he just leaves the rook hanging. I'm not threatening knight d3. If I go c5, he goes rook e4. Okay. This is possibly not my best game. All my pieces are trapped. Even getting my way out of this knot is going to take a lot of work. So we'll start with b6. Because this at least lets me sack the bishop if things go perfectly. Which they won't. Wait, no, he's got knight e4 now. And knight c4. Well, I'm gonna get the bishop out, one way or another. Yeah, I've got a queen and a knight that he does not have. But this isn't as terrible as it looks. Okay, we'll get the lure the king over. And now if knight c5, I think he does king d2. It's not so simple. Knight c5, king d2, queen d2. Sacks the bishop somewhere. And I don't have a way to force the rook to take things. So I'm going to pin the king to this pawn. Yeah, thanks, Vish. Yeah. I was glad. It wasn't entirely my effort either. Got some collaboration for a nice fellow in Germany. But yeah, I'm glad to see progress being made. YOLO! Okay. yeah, and it's good to see. And finally, they came up with a good way to test it, playing it against itself. And with that kind of framework, they were able to work out some of the rough edges that the engine faced. Ooh, what's this? So this is forced. This is... Oh. Okay, this is probably bad. Oh, wait. I am so lucky. Oh, except I miscounted. Yeah. No, this is brilliant on his part. I should have just taken the bishop. What am I thinking? Anyway, the brilliant conclusion is knight takes king, bishop c2, and then a3. I have to take everything with the knight. Yeah, anti-chess is difficult. That's probably not happening for some time. So, how many games would I have to win in a row to win this event? Also, maybe, here, let's play that knight h3 thing that the other dude played. If a 2300 can play it, I can pretend that I can play it. Okay, yeah, I'm out of book. I'm so out of book. Here. I'm gonna put my knight on f4, just because it looks funny there. probably not a good reason to play a move. I might even be able to play 2d3. Now that would throw off some opponents, that's for sure. I'll have to take that. Right, I forgot if you can take something. No, I just didn't see I could take it. So, that's me calculating. We'll say at a negative depth, just because my calculation was that awesome. Okay, but if he takes my queen, this is an easy win by force. So now it's a question of which pawn does his queen take. Okay, so he takes that one. I'm going to take here. I was going to take there regardless. I'm just trying to randomize this a bit. Because the more chaos we have, I don't know. The more opportunity there is for me to calculate and or miscalculate something. Wait, now he takes a2 if I do that. See, I can see one move deep sometimes. Do I do rook g1? Rook g1, queen b1, rook g7, queen takes something, rook takes, yeah, we're gonna try it. Oh, the other thing I could have considered seriously was bishop b5. That would have been interesting. Having a rampaging bishop. Yeah, what would you do with that? Okay, so I can just take all these pawns on the second rank. This tends to maximize my options and minimize his. So yeah, I get that my rook is locked in. But the fact that I could either capture the rook or this b6 pawn at the end of the sequence gives me tons of options, so I think I'm doing just fine here. I could be mistaken. So I think I have to take b8, and he takes my rook, I take, and I think I'm still doing well. Everything else is pretty terrible. Actually, wait. No, wait. If I move, if I take f1, he moves his knight, and I die. So this is forced. And now this is forced. Or at least this is best, because it keeps the most of his pawns on the board. If I had taken... Yeah, actually, if I take an a7, he gets to sack all his pawns, then sack the queen. Something like that. But now, I'm going to be forced to take on f8, assuming he plays rook f8, which I think would be a mistake. This rook tension thing is pretty irrelevant in this particular position because there are so many pawns still on the board. I just want to make sure that my rook doesn't end up on the fifth rank where it would end up capturing both of these pawns. Now, as much as I want to promote to a rook, that doesn't work here. I guess I take a king. It's not so easy. We're gonna try king. Oh, it's too bad though, I didn't put my rook behind my pawn. That would have allowed for more tactical possibilities. Yeah, so now it's easier for me to sack my king. Not only that, but if I sack it on d6, I could sack the rook right afterward. Wait, his rook's trapped, isn't it? So I could play rook e3. He plays any move I have to take, he has to take my rook. But that doesn't do anything for my king. It leaves my king in a very sad state. Yeah, we're just gonna keep marching the king forward. And if I push my king up, he pushes the pawn. Yeah, no, this is good. See, I know an endgame or two. Okay, promote to any piece. This is a win for white. Yeah. Whew, that was tricky. Yeah, I should try that knight h3 thing more often, I suppose. I know everybody plays g3 or e3 on move 1. Sometimes they play b3. But knight h3 looks fun. Alright. Lol Queen. Great name. Oh. Alright, he goes berserk. Can I take the pressure? Here, let's play knight h6 and see where we go. If knight h3 is okay, hopefully knight h6 is fine. Have I got him thinking? Is this move one something he's never seen before? If so, that's kind of cool. Do I take H1? I mean, why not? What could possibly be wrong with this capture? I take a thing, you take a thing. I have to take this thing. Okay, now if he plays there, I have to take that. Now if he uses King D1, I have to take the bishop. So there might be some things that were wrong with my opening play. Really, it's just a throw of the dice to see if I'm gonna get a position that I can save. So I could play B5. It doesn't work so well. Yeah, no, this is kind of forced. Unfortunately, he just moves the knight out of the way. Or does that. Well, might as well sack the queen, right? Where do I want to sack it? Do I have to decide right away? I do not. Here, make a decision. It's gonna be probably king takes. Yeah. So how does White win this? I can get away with this move, right? I'm threatening Bishop C4. One unfortunate. Oh, okay. This gets complicated. Actually, no. I have to, this is best. I should sack the bishop. Yeah, then make some space for me to sack my king. Gotta sack here. And then decide what to do about this pawn. Can I get away with Rook H8 or Rook B8? Yeah, I think Rook B8's my best move, which is really surprising. Yeah, and I'm not so afraid of the king sack there. So the key point here is that he cannot promote to a rook. He's got to promote to something else. Probably a bishop. So I could draw with rook h3. It's probably my best play. Oh, no, I'm gonna see where this goes. Oh, I now have a much better idea of where that goes. All of a sudden. So I have to take a king here, and I'm kind of screwed. Oh wait, no, he doesn't. He can't play B8 right away, because I have A6. Bishop d7 was not the finest play ever. Haha! Victory is mine! Okay. Well, that was ridiculous. That endgame is something you'll not see very often. But yeah, Bishop d7, I'm pretty sure, is like atrocious. Well, at least it gives me the tempi to. Gives me two tempi, one to play a5, one to play a4. It makes it that much more likely that I can achieve a draw under ideal circumstances. So, with that, I'm in the top 10. Somehow. Did not expect that. Apparently, Lee Chess didn't expect that either, because it took like a minute or two to pair me there. Okay, so 2300 dude can play knight h3. I can play knight h3. I'm out of book. Being perfectly honest with you, I don't know what's going on here. So the other game I played knight f4. I was saying that maybe after this I could actually get away with d3. I want to know just how bad d3 is after knight h3. Okay, so I'm trying to figure out if bishop takes, bishop g7, bishop b2, bishop there, bishop there, bishop here. And there's something here I'm missing. That bishop g7, I take, he takes. I mean, something about this just looks off. Well, we're gonna find out just how this goes, because I know that little about opening theory. Yeah, I bet the 2300 dude probably knows beyond move one. Probably. But hey, at least this way I get to like wreak havoc on the opening statistics by playing interesting openings and probably losing with them. Okay, so I have to take one of two different things here. Yeah, honestly I'm not seeing any advantage to taking h7 here, so d7 it is. Probably king takes. King takes is pretty thematic in general. Antichess. Let's see, do I still have that alias out here, that command? Yeah, I still got it. Nice. So that's Antichess. Okay, so question here is, can I do bishop g2? It looks scary. Bishop g2, queen h3. Bishop a8, queen h2, rook h2, rook moves. Ooh, that's no good. Probably should have calculated that before getting this far. Because there's really nothing I can do to salvage it at this point. Other than, I don't know, duck and cover. Duck and cover is going to be the strategy here. Okay, so my bishop's not roaming the board. It's kind of a miracle. The better player does win, but your definition of better depends on, I don't know. But yeah, a stronger player will win the game. All right, I'm gonna take one of those. This is pretty embarrassing. I have like one legal move that doesn't lose the game. Well, no, Rook G1 might be okay. If Rook G1's okay, we have to play it, just because it's that ridiculous. All right, here we go, Rook G1. Because otherwise, if I start pushing this pawn, he's going to stack his pieces onto this pawn, and then my rook's going to get loose on the h file. So, might as well play it to the g file while he's got two pieces covering that, two pieces covering that, and two pieces covering that. Sack it while I have the one opportunity to do so. Make a crude threat of just pushing here, pushing there, and knight takes everything. Of course he saw it. Of course he reacted. Oh, wait, no, he's got knight d7. I thought I saw something. It's not at all there. All right, so we're gonna just develop the knight. Yep, there's knight d7, as predicted. Okay. I guess I'm playing knight b3 and hoping some miracle happens. So he can't just. I mean, he could put a piece on f6, but it's not that great. So this pawn is slowly moving forward, taking things. Not sure why he did that. Pick your poison. Okay. So now I want to sack my bishop. Easier said than done. Much easier said than done. Funny enough, my best move might be bishop g2. Okay, we're gonna sack the pawn. Then bishop g2, taking out the one rook. Because no other piece can make its way to this diagonal at this time. Actually, he's got knight e7. Okay, well, that puts us into a kind of interesting endgame. Actually, he's got knight c6 here, which makes it a lot less interesting. Oh, he doesn't. Oh, right. I knew that. All right, let's get this pawn moving. Oh crap. Oh, I'm so good. Oh well, that's too bad. If I'd taken a king, that would have been a really long, prolonged, painful endgame. He found the one and only way that won the game for him there, but that's all it takes. I thought I calculated everything. I missed that variation. And that's what anti-chess is like. So you got to budget your time while playing this game. because things can happen. Basically, anti-chess in a nutshell, right there. Alright, you take a thing, I take a thing. I can confuse you more than you can confuse me, because I'm already confused. Hey, check this out. See, I'm attacking this pawn? See, he can't do anything to not protect it. Okay. Sure. Of course I'll let this happen. Here, take my queen. Take my king. Take my rook. Take my pawn. Let's see, how do I conclude this? This. Take my pawn, take my knight, take this pawn, take that pawn, take this pawn. Here you go. That's what the majority of amateur anti-chess games look like, by the way. One player just ends up moving a bishop about and taking the entire board. And when anti-chess was initially released on Lee Chess, that's kind of how a lot of the games went. But it seems a lot of the players have wisened up a bit. Okay. What do you play against knight h3? Oh, g5 he plays. Okay. Not that I was expecting anything, but I didn't expect that. Okay, so take my pawn. Did I confuse him with that g3 move? Oh, now I see why he's confused. Okay, well, I'm gonna sack my bishop one way or another. I might have to take a knight pawn and who knows what else to get this bishop off the board. That's one fewer thing for me to worry about. There's calculation stuff to do. Yeah, we're just gonna sack. We're gonna open as many lines as possible. Oh, king takes. Right. Okay. Okay, I'm gonna sack my bishop somehow. Don't know what's a priority in this position. Let's develop my king so that he can't develop his. Now knight a6, I'm sure. That's not knight a6. Okay. Getting rid of my knight could be a problem. I think I have to do this right away. Oh, okay, so he's intending. Yeah, I can't resist that. I could put up some resistance, but it doesn't last long. That's kind of a problem. So the best I can really do is just push this. Actually, that was pretty bad. So, yeah, now I have to push, and he's going to sack both the pawns and then find a way to get rid of the knight. Well, we're taking a bishop. And then pulling some kind of miraculous nonsense here. Yeah, I think I got this. So c3, knight takes. e4. Well, no, not there. f4, probably. I saw something a minute ago, but it doesn't work. Yeah, c3. He takes that. King f4. King f3. Knight takes king. And then I win by stalemate. Oh yeah, is that the number one seeded dude in the tournament? Oh. Wow, it's a tough break for him. I assume he just got overconfident and that I didn't play some brilliant masterpiece of a game, but you know, maybe I did. Maybe I just proved that the game is completely winning for black. All right. Here, we'll do. Oh, uh-oh. Uh-oh. This is not looking good. Thankfully, there's no e3 on the board. But this game's gonna be over very quickly. And we'll know soon who won it. It's probably not me. Probably not. Obviously he missed queen takes h2. Although actually far stronger was queen takes c1, right? And then I take b1 and his rook mops up my back rank. But we'll pretend that I'm playing the good moves. And I didn't miss something brilliant. You guys are with me on that, right? Nobody saw any of that stuff that I missed. So we're gonna sack the bishop. Oh, I forgot. My knight moves this way. So it's probably gonna be over quickly, as I was saying. Okay, can we get one game for the last minute and a half of the tournament? I'm gonna guess no. Either way, I gained 66 points this event, so that's not terrible. Made it into the top 10. And of the players who are still playing in the event, I'm in the top 5. All these other guys withdrew just because either they won or they can't win. Or they had to go. I don't know. Or they're afraid that I'm going to take their rating points. Yeah, that's definitely it. Alright, so it's the last minute of the tournament. There's no way I'm getting a pairing. So, can we see whatever's going on board one just magically appear over in this little corner? Please? Well, looks like I'm probably not going to make a top 10. If anybody scores a half point, or scores to make it into the top 10 in this last 30 seconds, I'm probably getting kicked out of the top 10 club. Still, it's encouraging to see that I can play moves like Knight H3 and have fun games, so. Alright, let's see the standings. Alright. Oh wow, this dude went berserk 90% of the time. Or he won 90% when he went berserk, I don't know. But that's pretty cool. So yeah, that's anti-chess in a nutshell. Not among the top people on the site at that at all. Let's see, what rating should I try to, like, a number of my ratings. I used to have a established rating in every category, and most of them have fallen off. Wait, have I still not gotten an established anti-chess rating? Let's see. No, I got a rating deviation of 66 points, so we'll see that I'll have a rating starting off here on the graph soon. Which one do I want to try to get back into next? Probably King of the Hill. I used to play this all the time. Wait. I've got an RD of 63, so I still have an established rating for King of the Hill. But why don't I see it on the graph? It's just because I haven't played games recently. I don't understand this graph. But that's cool. Let's just pick a tournament. See what's going on. Most of these are an hour-long event. There's the Waitskin 3-0. It's almost done. This one's almost done, too. Well, we'll play what the fans keep clamoring for. They all want the bullet. We'll try bullet. I'm going to lose all my points, but who cares? It's just for fun. Oh, wait. I forgot. Some time ago, I had played a whole bunch of blindfolded hyperbullet. So I actually have some rating points to gain back here. Perhaps not against this dude. This dude might pose a challenge. Alright, can we fried liver it up? No, we can't. Okay. No, that's not the move at all. Apparently, I don't know the theory. That's okay. Maybe. I wasn't intending to go for the cheapo, but then it just became irresistible. Okay, so wait, now that drops a piece. Let's go over here. Plug a knight up here. Sure, whatever. Oh, that's gambling a pawn. We'll call this a warm-up game then. Obviously, this is just me testing that my mouse works. Because I'm hanging all my pieces and not even seeing that I'm hanging them. Sure, go checkmate me. That's kind of crazy. Let's pull back here. Nice. Well spotted, sir. Gotta take that. Pretty sure I'm not winning this on time, or by any other means, so we'll just call it there. So, pieces go forward, pieces go backward. Getting paired with the 2400 in round one after I haven't played bullet in a few weeks is probably not the best way to start the event, but we'll make do. Okay, so if you're not going to take me, I'll just force it this way. We take here, take there. I'm not going to double your pawns in this kind of time control. Pawn structure becomes a rather secondary consideration. I say as now I take it, because I'm cramped. Oh, didn't mean to put my queen there. Okay. We'll just somehow make a plan out of it. Sure. Stick the king on f8. It's kind of invincible there. Kick the queen. Try to kick it again. Yep. This is not going well. okay. This could be going better. There we go. I found a more optimistic way to phrase it. Oh, hey, look, I'm in check. No, I'm not. He didn't check me. He forgot to check me. Oh, he saw it. Oops, that's mate. He found it. Alright. Two in a row, guys. Can we make it three? Let's make it three. Do the three-peat. Oh, hey, look, a free pawn. These people are good at noticing hanging stuff. Not so good at the checking stuff, but, so, here's how you win multiple pieces in the opening. You take the rook, and you go back, and you take the knight. And maybe he does queen takes pawn. I attack the queen and lure him away and do something clever. I want there to be queen c8 mate. Oh, it's not happening. Well, it looks like I'll just have to promote this guy. Most people have heard of Tigran Petrosian. This Taurus Petrosian, perhaps not so famous. He did make it out of the opening, though. Gotta give him that one. Well, he almost got to castle. King d7 might not have been accurate. Thanks. Oh, let's play this. Yeah, now if I were brilliant, that bot stuff could have happened forever ago. It's just a lot of hard work. Okay, take my knight. Protect my pawn. Are we going to see g4? Are we going to see g4? I'm guessing no. Actually, I could just... No, I can't take... Nope. Taking on h3 is not so bright. But now it's a little bit better. Here, I'll take one of those. Now I can take there. Maybe. I've certainly given him a thing or two to think about. Yeah, I don't play Sicilian very often. I do sometimes play it, but usually not in 1-0. It's kind of difficult to develop your pieces. I don't know. Unless you open e5 or d5 on move 1. I see the Murder Castle's still at it. It's kind of a cool name. Alright. Here, let's play d5. Nobody suspects the center counter. Let's go back here. And this one. And then that one. And then bring the knight forward. And bishop forward. And hey, look, we've almost got an opening. Hey, look, I almost hung a piece. And we didn't even get to move 10. Okay, right. So that's legal. This is me losing an exchange if he spots knight g5 instead of that. But he didn't, so I made it out in one piece. And now we attack. Oops, I dropped a bishop. Yeah, but see, if you'd play queen d8 there, you don't get the cool checkmate. Gotta play for the cool checkmates in bullet. Oh man, if he opened e5, I was totally gonna go bishop c4 and queen h5. Just to go for the cool mate again. Alright, you pin me. Well, that's not the pin I expected. Because now you have to take that. Or your bishop's kind of misplaced. Oops. Well. Guys, we're inventing theory here. And by that I mean this is probably not best. Oh, hey, look, free pawn. Free pawn with bishops on the long diagonal. What more could one ask for? I could ask for a checkmate. You think I'm gonna get it? I wager not. But hope springs eternal. Hitting this guy. Okay, we'll take that. Hitting this. And we'll use this knight. Yeah, I don't want to keep my queen on that diagonal any longer. We'll try this one. Okay, we'll take the knight. Go back here. Probably should have taken this. Yeah. Oh well, I missed it. What you gonna do? Oh, actually, my knight's defended. It's not like I'm sacking anything to do this. Oh, has this been hanging the whole time? Okay, I'm just gonna look brilliant and imagine I calculated all that from the beginning. Take one of those. Oh. He ran out of time. Just when the fun part was getting started. How dare he run out of time? Alright. Here, let's throw this out there. See how many pawns we can give up. He plays b5, or doesn't. Either way, I do this. I'm gonna go back. And step over here, move that up, move my other rook to d1. It's just so much more comfortable to play this, the white side of this. Because worst case, you're giving up a pawn. Best case, you're winning a king. So it tends to work out pretty well for white, at least in this time control. I can totally understand other time controls you might want to play Sicilian, but playing it in 1-0 seems kind of nuts. See, I got my pawn back. Nothing for me to worry about. Alright, so we'll get the skewer going. Oh, this doesn't actually win the bishop or anything cool like that. So move that forward. Bring that over. Sure, protect this. Protect that. Take one of those. Get the king out of dodge. Keep getting out of dodge. Take one of those. One of these. Check. And yeah. You don't trade queens when you have 5 seconds left. Unless you have some really specific aim. Ah. Yeah. Okay, fine. We'll do the Sicilian. We'll do it live. Here. Oh, look. How do you like that one? Came up with that on the spot. Isn't that a great opening? Nobody suspects whatever that was. Isn't it super effective? Alright, so that was pretty silly. There's so much cheese on that, you would think it's a pizza. Alright, so I need to get this knight over that way. A knight d4 is probably reasonable. Why didn't I do knight d4? Maybe it was too reasonable. Okay, oh, we're out of the pin. We're out of the discovery. I don't want that check. Maybe I could have won an exchange, but it looked scary. I'll take one of those, go forward. Keep moving forward. Demonstrate why we play all the end games. Zugzwang. GG. GG no re. Okay. Okay, he did resign. See, the next part is you play h2 and his king doesn't get to move, and then you promote one of your other pawns. And they just can't do anything about it. Let's go back here. Hey look, I trapped a knight. Isn't it great? Why do people play these refuted openings? Oh wait, this guy's 2390. How great is that? I just cheesed him because I was having fun. I didn't actually realize he had a rating. That's pretty cool. I'm sure he likes that. Can't do that check. I could do this one. I could do that one. Oh, he protects the pawn. Well, that's an omen. Well, that was okay. I made it. I forgot that there was a clock there. But, you know, whatever works, works. I'm almost back to 2000 again. Oh, here we go. Let's Philidor it up. Okay. I should just get my king out of here. There's a fork. Probably gonna have another fork in a second here. I mean, I could do knight b3. Yeah, I should probably do that now. Stop the queen from taking a7. Stop it again. Maybe I could trap a queen? Doubtful. Alright. We'll do something about these aggressively posted pieces. Okay, sure. We can do that. Take one of those. Take one of those. Well, I drew the 2390. I did not defeat him. At least I'm pretty sure I lost the my timed out first, so I only get 10 points for a draw, which is actually pretty generous. Because a draw really doesn't do much to prove my strength. Oops, I hung the pawn. Whatever. Right there. Go back. Over here. Protect that. Just walking blindly into a pin. Alright. Get out of the pin. Maybe. Maybe just walk into a worse form of it. Alright. Get our endgame. Everybody enjoys endgames. That might hang stuff. Let's move this over. Okay. Check. Not sure what to do here. Let's put the rook over there. Just give him something to think about. One fun trap, is it not? Alright. Suppose I do have to run back. Oh, right. Now I'm actually hanging stuff here. Well, so let's go back. I might be losing that with 4 seconds remaining and no threats. That might not be working so well. Yeah. That's what happens when you go all in on one idea. And it's the wrong idea. But it looks so cool when it works, so sometimes you just have to go for it. Oh, what was that? That's me pushing things and not seeing pretty close range consequences. Hey, look, I'm hanging more stuff. Bishop, go back, bring this out. I shouldn't have pre-moved that. What was I thinking? That was a really risky pre-move. Let's get out here. Yeah, I might not be winning that one either. So my no, I'm nowhere near 2,000 at the moment. Might need to play better moves. Let's go forward. Let's try playing better moves. Hey, look, the self-pin. Isn't it great? Always pin your own pieces. There's no way that could ever go wrong. Hey, I got a pawn. That was awesome. Let's get the king out. Over here, rook up, check, take the pawn. Oh, am I going to do a Nigel short? How great would that be? Hope you studied your rook endgames. Yeah. Oh, that didn't count for the tournament. But I still got 5 rating points. 6th place. Not terrible. Especially considering that Lance took 3rd. 6th for me is pretty cool. Lance went berserk a lot. He likes to do that. Next tournament's the Hourly Bullet Arena. Wait, what? Oh, so sometimes they alternate bullet and hyper bullet, and that ridiculously fast hyper bullet freaks me out. Wait. Am I rated under 2,000? Could I play that ridiculous under 2,000 thing? No, I'm 2117. I was gonna say, even though my bullet rating's suffering, I'm not eligible for this Blitz Increment Arena. Well, we can't end it on that note, and I don't feel like playing in the next tournament. So, sure, let's put a Seek out there. A couple games to cool down here. Get the king out of the way. Yeah, the bullet tournament is way more fast-paced than this. At least in terms of opponent's moves. So you could take here. He doesn't have to, but he could. Okay, we'll take one of those. And one of these. One of those. Actually just defend this. Okay, sure. Why not? Take one of these. Let's go back. Threaten one of those. Probably should have just moved the bishop there to win the exchange, but you know, we'll take what we can find. All right. D4. Here, let's try the Slav. That, okay. So much for that idea. Let's try this opening. The Queen's Gambit Chigorin something. Can I take that? Ah, he saw it. Can I do knight check? That's not check, but can I do that knight fork? Nope. Okay. So now we're in some kind of weird Queen's Gambit declined thing, maybe? I don't know. But we're not in Kansas anymore. This is a reverse Queen's Gambit accepted. So I should be pushing these pawns if we're doing positional chess. Which I assure you we're not. Okay. That's a free piece. That's another free piece. Is this actually? No, it's not a free queen. How great would it be? But it's not. Okay, I'll take one of those. Oh, I'm pinned. Oh noes. Just pretend I saw all this. Check. That's a fancy way to trade pieces. Alright. We're not getting checkmated there. Maybe. Free stuff. Oh, I went on time. Well, that's pleasant. I saw I have 5 seconds left. I didn't look at his clock. Check. Alright, somebody tell me if this is sound. It's not sound. But whatever. Here, why sack one piece when you can sack two? Oh, I could have trapped the bishop. That would have at least gotten one piece back. Oh well. Oh, I did not see that that protects the queen. Well, that makes my little skirmish not so effective. Okay, let's just develop a piece. Why be down two pieces when you could be down three? But well, there's got to be some way I can make some progress here. To go back. And now we run the pawns. Okay. Oh, hang on, that's another knight. That's actually a rook if I wanted it. Apparently I didn't. Alright, so... nobody suspects this thing. We have to try to make it interesting. You know, if I keep win by taking hanging pieces, then I have to play more and more obtuse openings until I finally find a move where my opponents can beat me. So far I have not succeeded in finding a sufficiently obtuse move. But we're getting there. I have every confidence that sometime in the next 30 to 50 games, I'll find a move that successfully does not win by force. Alright, so yeah, he's winning another pawn. There's nothing I can do about that. Well, okay, so I have to play this. Otherwise, F7's dropping for nil. Let's pin this. Take one of those. And now I got three pieces attacking the knight. He's got two defending. He's got a third defending it, but man, I don't like this position of his. Oh, that might work out. Well, that's unfortunate. We'll just go back. Check. Okay. I had to do it. You don't get that far and then not check. How awesome would it be, though, if he pre-moved to take that piece? I mean, what would be the odds that my opponent would win against that particular move? He would have had to pre-move, knowing what I was going to do, basically. I'd like to think that my moves are not that predictable. See the bishop? Bishop covers b8. Yep. Free stuff. Just go back. Go over and trade rooks. Take one of those. Check. Take one of those. Check here. Check here. Another check. And choose not to get mated. Oh, that's a nice little fork. I have to go back here. Totally not threatening anything. Check. Go over this way. There we go. I found it. I don't know why he keeps hitting the rematch button. He must be having a lot of fun doing this. I hope. Let's do something about g4. Prepare e5 somehow. Let's play this. I like all these open squares. Queen trades somehow. Oh. So I get this pawn for free. I'm hitting this. Let's bring the other rook over. Just keep hitting that. Just keep hammering away. Check. Let's transfer to this. If queen b2, I take it. Not making any threat whatsoever. Actually, he's got knight g5. It only loses the rook. Yeah, he actually missed a really strong knight g5 earlier. Like back here, if he just played knight g5, well, it looks strong. Does it mate? I don't know. But yeah, clearly I'm not playing very objectively at the moment. Oh, but I did get over 2,000. So, hooray for that. Let's see. Let's check out the tournaments. Is there one I want to play in? Yeah, let's play a little Crazy House. Just a little bit of Crazy House, and then we'll wrap it up. Wait, this is 3-0, so I have maybe time for three or four games, depending how they go. Oh, okay, yeah, this one's gonna be over very quickly. Probably. Right, so I walked into a pin. So far we're on a good start. Let's protect that. Now he just stomps on me with knight d4. Okay. Now he plays like this. Oh, okay, that's pretty good too. I'm in check. Yeah, okay. I'm getting mated, so GG. All right, that game was quick. Like I was saying, maybe time for three or four of these. Key point is that my king only has two squares. If I do king g2, he does knight at h4 and then pawn at g2 mate. If I do king h1, I think he plays just pawn g2 and then knight at h4. Same combination in either order. Yeah, you're right. This ain't anti-chess. After solving anti-chess, I just decided to retire from it. And come back here and play some Crazy House. They called me the Intergalactic Anti-Chess Champion. Invented a new, I don't know, title for me. Delivered a pizza in my honor. And yeah. For now, I took a break from anti-chess there. Though if you check the video on demand, you'll see I was playing at least an hour of it. And I showed some good endgame moves. At least I was amused by them. Maybe you weren't. Okay, wait, I can't play f6 here because that would drop the bishop. So here we go, maybe. All right, we'll exchange here. I'll just hit that. I assume he does bishop g5. Yeah, I didn't really have anything planned against that, per se. Oh, I'm forced to capture, aren't I? Let's just move the king away. He who fights and runs away lives to run away another day. hit this. I get the sensation that I might be dropping stuff here. Oh, hey, look, that's an accidental pin. That actually profits me in some way. So I threaten to take your queen. You take back. I have to move my queen. Oh, there aren't very many good squares to move it to. This is one of the better ones, and that's not really helping. Thankfully, he doesn't have enough pieces to checkmate me. So it gives me some time to put the pieces back on the board and put up some resistance. Perhaps I've been playing too much Bug House lately. Maybe that's interfering with my crazy house. Ooh, this might hurt. Yeah, and I'm kind of forced to give up my queen. Let's take that. I might be surviving this, maybe? Oh, no, I'm definitely not. Just kidding about that whole surviving thing. Does he see it? Does he see it? He sees it. Alright, well, that was too bad. So, I've only lost 16 points so far. Come on. Can you give me another opponent? Somebody I can, like... Can you give me somebody else at the top of the tournament? Because that's what you seem to be doing this tournament. Either that or there's just a lot of really strong players. No. Tournament's just like, you joined late. I'm going to give you the 2400 or whatever he was. Then I'm going to give you 2100. And now I'm going to give you, like, a 1300 who doesn't know how the pieces move. That's how Swiss tournament, or not Swiss, but it's just how tournaments go in general. You don't tend to get paired with players your own strength until maybe halfway through the event. Just in general. And that gives everybody a chance to play stronger and weaker players. Unless, you, of course, you happen to be one of the very strongest or very weakest players in the event. So I'm sure any minute now, it might consider thinking about how to pair me. There we go, we got a pairing. 1300, I called it. I so called it. Did you not hear me call it? I'm going to guess next round's probably an 1800. Unless I lose this, and then it'll probably give me the 1200 who's sitting at the bottom. I'm going to wager that this is playable, even though I'm not sure. This is known as the fried liver attack in normal chess. I assume it works in Crazy House, but... Maybe there's some nuance which makes it not work as well or something. Here. Oh, he resigns. Okay. I would have played that out.
But I guess it's frustrating getting your king smoked out and having your pawns scattered all over. But his king was actually relatively safe there. But okay, I'll take it. Because I had to sack a knight to get that attack in the first place, so the fact that I happen to win a piece just puts us back more or less to material equality. He takes, I take back. And I'm up two bishops. Let's just put one of the bishops here. Although it's a bishop for a pawn, so maybe it's not as strong as it looks. I'm not so worried about this. So we got material equality back on the board, but I still think I'm doing strongly here. Yeah, I got the piece back when I took the knight. So I'm just saying we got back to material equality or somewhere around there. Certainly not something I would have resigned over. Okay, I was considering Queen G5 for a second there. That might not have been my best candidate move ever. Now I know he wants a bishop so he can put it there, and yeah, it's not gonna happen. I was considering Queen G4. I might want to consider something else. Really? That's interesting. I really want to take that, so I'm gonna take it. Not because I think it's best, but just because I really want to see where this goes. So I'm noticing that he has all his pieces on the board. A lot of my pieces are not on the board. I missed that. That's okay. Here, you take my queen, I take your queen. We get into kind of a race here. It's a little sad that I'm getting pushed around. That's just saying that I'm not playing very well. So this makes kind of an empty threat. Should probably just play queen. Well, now queen g3 loses on the spot. But it's not so easy to keep up a sustained attack on my king. I've completely blanked on the fact that knight takes knight kind of wins a knight. I'm pretty scared to take that. Kind of have to do it though. And I'm probably dead here, but whatever. Nope, that loses my queen. This does not lose my queen because my bishop covers these squares, which would fork. If you put a knight there, that would fork my king and queen, but we can't do that. Here, are you going to take this one too? Probably. Because you take that one, then you could take g4. I'm sorry, you take g4 first, and then you could take e5. I take back, then you fork me, I move my king. Right.
I'm not backing off from this, though. Oh, I missed that one, too. But yeah, this is supposed to be pretty scary. I'm not going to let him have two queens running around my king. Oh, I missed queen e6, king d8, knight f7, mate. So if he does queen e6, I have to go the other way. Which he didn't do. So I'll just go this way. Yeah, I have to take that. I have to go. Wait, no. If he takes, I have the option to go this way. So now we block. Oh, and there, except he has no piece to drop there. Nope, we have to put the knight down. This is check. 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 This is too bad. I win! A brilliant victory on my part. Okay. I shouldn't take too much credit for that one. But I did win a game. So, that protects my rating, keeps my loss for this event at 12 points. Alright. Well, with that, you can see it's all downhill from here. So I should probably wrap it up. It's been fun playing. Hopefully my ramblings have been keeping some people entertained. Yeah, let's see, there's this latest blog post out here. Stockfish is learning. You may know about Stockfish, the strongest chess player in the known universe. It's a fantastic chess AI. And like all the greatest programs, it's open source and actively maintained by enthusiasts. Naturally, we use it on LeeChess. You can play against the computer, request computer analysis, or do local analysis, which is Stockfish in JavaScript form. Out of the box, it plays standard chess and Chess 960. But you know, it's open source, so let's have some fun with it, play all the other variants, you know, King of the Hill, 3 Check, Atomic Horde, and Racing Kings. You think it's crazy? It's open source and we're all enthusiasts, so why not enjoy this stuff, right? Yeah, it's a great collaborative effort. I particularly like the opening book and endgame table-based stuff that we got here, too. Maybe one day we'll have endgame table bases for variants. Wouldn't that be awesome? It's probably a long, long way off. I had to guess, but that'd be kind of cool. But yeah, Stockfish is learning. Alright, so hope you guys enjoyed. Hope I didn't bore you too much. So thanks for watching, and I'll see you guys next time.